It is the Election Bureau. Welcome to the Citi Newsroom. My name is Vivian Kai Lokko.
And mine is Umaru Sanda Amadu. Coming up.
Four former MPs sacked from Parliament, but did the Speaker go contrary to parliamentary rules?
Later, we'll take you to the Famina constituency, where some constituents are not happy with the latest development there.
And also coming up, Special Prosecutor Martin Amadu hits back at former President Mahama for labeling him as a coward by deferring investigations into the controversial Airbus scandal.
Still on the Citi Newsroom, with a few weeks to election 2020, how prepared is the Electoral Commission? We'll be finding out.
Independent presidential candidate Alfred Walker promises to institute a policy to stop the monthly payment of salaries if voted into power. Let's bring you details of our stories. And the Speaker of Parliament, Professor Michael Quay, over the weekend notified the Electoral Commission that the Fomena constituency seat has been declared vacant.
In October, the governing New Patriotic Party wrote to the Speaker with a request for the seat to be declared vacant following the decision of the incumbent MP, Andre Siamamwaku, to contest the 2020 polls as an independent candidate.
But what are the consequences of this Speaker's action? Our correspondent has more.
On October 13th this year, the New Patriotic Party wrote to the Speaker of the House to declare the Fomina seat vacant following the decision of the incumbent MP, Andrew Isiamamwaku, to contest as an independent candidate. The MPP based its request on Article 97(1)(g) of the 1992 Constitution. At the time, experienced legislators told City News the decision will be a tough one for the Speaker. MP for Boku Central, Mahama Ayariga, and MP for Ikuyapim South, Osebunsu Amua, expressed views on how the Speaker should deal with the matter at hand.
He is entitled to come and sit in Parliament and participate and debate until the end of his tenure of office as a member of Parliament. An MPP has no power whatsoever to withdraw him from Parliament.
You look at the Constitution first and our standing orders, and then we decide to either get a committee to look at it or we look at the rules here and elsewhere and decide that we pronounce on it. And then it's for the MP to also defend himself as to why the party should still see him as their rep.
The Speaker, Professor Michael Quay, on Saturday, November 7th, notified the House of the vacancy of the Fomina seat with this justification.
This lacuna of a ridiculous situation is not what is anticipated under the 1992 Constitution. In the circumstances, Parliament has, it is determined that the conduct of Honorable Andrew Amwaku Asiama amounts to vacating his seat in Parliament. Accordingly, we bring this to the notice of the Electoral Commission for the necessary action to be taken in accordance with the law.
But ranking member on the Constitutional, Legal and Parliamentary Affairs Committee of the House, Inusa Fuseni, is of the view that the Speaker should have allowed members debate the notification to the House.
What the Speaker did is to curtail the debate on the matter, because there are many people who have different views on this matter. And I think Speaker did not want it to descend into a debating, a boxing arena where everybody will get up and be expressing views which might throw the House out of control.
Inusa Fuseni entered Parliament after the conduct of a by-election in 2006, when the incumbent NDC MP, Dr. Wayoseni, crossed carpet from the NDC to the MPP, an action that triggered an immediate vacation of the seat. He tells City News what the ramifications of the decision could be.
The consequences are that the Fomina seat, the Fomina MP, the city MP of Fomina, whose seat has been declared vacant, will otherwise not be entitled to the November and December salaries. In the calculations of his end of year benefits, he will also not be entitled to the November-December computation. November-December cannot be added to the computation of his end of service benefits. So that is the consequences of any declaration.
Andrea Mwakwesiama, however, remains upbeat about his chances despite the declaration of his seat as vacant.
The issue is that I'm winning. If that is what you want to know, I'm winning. Else, I wouldn't have even raised my chances. right? I'm a sitting member of parliament. I'm not oblivious of all the consequences that is associated with the step I'm taking. But I'm taking that steps. That tells you that I know what I'm doing. I'm winning.
Andrew Amwakwesiama withdrew from the contest for the seat before the MPP organized primaries earlier in the year and subsequently filed to contest as an independent candidate. It is important to note that per the dictates of Article 1126, there will not be a by-election for the Fomina seat because the vacancy has been declared within 3 months to the holding of a general election.
Meanwhile, Ghanaian law professor Kweku Asare says the Speaker of Parliament had no authority to declare the Fomina seat vacant. According to him, only High Court has the power to do so. Speaking to Citi News, Professor Kweku Asare insisted that Mr. Isiama legally remains a member of parliament. Professor Asare also cautioned political parties not to abuse the law to punish their members who fall out with the party in parliament.
Read Article 99(1)(a). It is abundantly clear. It says that whenever a question arises, just a question, when a question arises, that question must be referred to the High Court, and it's only the High Court that has the jurisdiction to determine whether a seat has been vacated by a parliamentarian. And the reason for this is very simple, because parliament is a house of politicians, and you don't want to give politicians the power to determine whether a seat has been vacated or not, because it will turn into politics. Rather, it is a juridical question that has to be referred to judges, independent judges. The second problem is substantive. When you read Article 97(1)(g), you figure out that it says a member vacates his seat when he leaves the party on whose ticket he was elected to join another party, or he seeks to remain in parliament as an independent member. When you read this holistically and understand the purpose for which the article was written, you come up with two key points. One, it applies only to MPs because people can defect from their parties. Non-MPs can defect from their parties. This article, cross-carpet, is called the cross-carpeting article, only arises when MPs are involved, and then two, when MPs leave their parties to join other parties in a particular term of parliament. The order by the speaker is null and void. It's not the speaker's position to vacate seats. And so if he vacates a seat, it's a nullity. The law does not recognize it. He doesn't have the power. It's just like the speaker declaring that somebody has been elected president of Ghana. I mean, he can say that, but he doesn't have it.
So this is not the first time a member of parliament is vacating his seat and deciding to go independent. Actually, in our political history, we've seen quite a number of instances like this. Now, Citi News' Ni Ama Ama has been looking at that.
Independent candidates have heavily featured in Ghana's politics since the start of the Fourth Republic in 1992. The first parliament saw two of such candidates making it to the House. By 1996, three NDC members of parliament had decided to go independent after losing their slots at the party level. Emmanuel Kwame Boache of Ofensu North, Emmanuel Nate of Apamana, and M.M. Garnakikwe from Dadikotopong. In that year, 54 in all ran as independent candidates for parliament. By the end of the polls, all 54 lost the elections, including incumbent independent MPs from the 1992 elections, Hawa Yakubu from Boku Central and John Acholiwo from Navungo Central. In 2000, 63 independent candidates came up. This time, however, four made it. The four independent winners were all disgruntled NDC members after losing their primaries. Boniface Abubakar Siddiq from Salaga, Johnson Akudibila from Garutimpani, Rashid Bawa from Akan in the Volta region, and James Victor Beho from Anglo also in the Volta region. The number of independent candidates shot up to 126 in the 2004 elections, but only one would make it to the House. The independent win in Bankrugu Yoyo in the northern region was interesting. The candidate, Josefiani Labok, had won the seat twice before in 1992 and 1996 on the NDC ticket. After losing his nomination in 2000, he first contested as independent candidate and lost that year to the new NDC candidate. In 2004, however, he defeated him and won the seat. By the 2008 election, 96 independent candidates had emerged for parliament, 30 persons less than those who contested 4 years before. Four became successful at the end of the polls. All of them were disgruntled MPP members who had lost their primaries. This marked the entry of now First Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Joseph Osei Owusu. This caused the NPP 4 seats in the House, contributing to their loss of majority on the floor. In 2004, 45 more constituencies were created, pushing the seats up for grabs from 230 to 275. 120 independent candidates emerged, but only 3 won. All 3 were formerly with the NDC until they lost their nominations to run at the party level. In 2016, a number of independent candidates resurfaced, many of whom were members of the NDC or NPP who had lost their primaries. 3 of them were incumbent MPs, namely Alhassan Dahamani from Tamale North, Paul Deruguba from Juapa, and Joseph Ofoi from Akan. In the end, none of them won, leaving the 7th Parliament of the 4th Republic with no independent candidate. But in all these, never has a political party written to the Speaker of the House to expel a sitting MP for deciding to run independently. Law Professor Kwekwa Asare says the recent happenings surrounding the Fomina seat is unheard of.
Wayoseni used to be an NDC MP. Then they had a congress in Koforidua, and some of the delegates attacked him and Obeda Samoa. When he returned, he announced in parliament that he's no longer caucusing with the NDC, he's cross-carpet and he's joined NPP. And he further advised the speaker to activate Article 97(1)(g) to vacate his seat. That was a good example of how it should be used. On the other hand, if you look at Kenyanu, he was the MP for Lower Kobo, I think. He basically did not quit the NDC in parliament, but he chose to run in the next parliament as an independent. He was allowed to finish his term as an NDC MP, run as an independent MP, and I don't think he even won. The same thing with Dr. William Akoto. Dr. William Akoto was the MPP MP for Abirim, I think in 2000 to 2004. Then he was defeated in the MPP primary, but he chose to run as an independent in the next parliament. He did not have to vacate his seat.
Now, some constituents of the Fomina constituency in the Ashanti region have criticized the decision of the Speaker of Parliament to declare the Fomina seat vacant after the MP insisted on contesting as an independent candidate in the upcoming election.
Edward Opomafo has more.
The Fomina constituency has been in the headlines for some time now after the incumbent MP decided to run as an independent candidate. Well, there have been a number of issues. The MPP, of which he is part of, the road to parliament for him to be sacked as an MP. Subsequently, the Speaker of Parliament has ruled on it, and he says the seat is now vacant. Well, we're here to find out from the residents in the area to know from them what they think about this. We understand there are a number of communities within the constituency where there have been a number of agitations. So we're moving to those areas to find out what specifically the residents have been saying. This is the Akrokeri area. And we have gotten to an area where we know that people have mobilized. In fact, there are a group of people who have mobilized and they are protesting against that decision. Well, according to them, they will still go ahead and vote for him, even if he has been dismissed from parliament. So we're here to talk to some of the people here. So first of all, let me get to one of the supporters here. And in fact, he is against that decision. Tell us, why are you against this decision?
My name is Christopher, a constituent here. We are voting for Loyesema because of development. We've been having so many MPs since 92. This is the only MP that has done so much development infrastructures over here. When you go to Famina TI Amas, 450 boys dormitory. When you come to Akari here, Asaribediakon Secondary School. So you can see so many infrastructures here, true lawyer that he has done here. When you go to, since the time that I was born here, the police station we've been rented, but through lawyer we've gotten a new police station here, and you can just go there to verify for yourself. When you go to Chichere, we have chip compounds, everything. So you are voting for lawyer Andrew Samakwensiama come December 7th because of the
even if he's going as an independent and now he's been sacked from parliament.
Yes. Sure. Nothing will change our mind from voting for lawyer Amakwensiama. Yes.
All right, thank you very much. Let me get to you too. You too, I know you're part of this group and you're protesting against this decision. What is really motivating
you? Well, my issue is whether he's sacked or not. We are not looking at the party. We are looking at the individual. Are you getting me? The man is working.
Yes.
Are you getting me? NPP is a subset of Adansimai. We are looking for the man who help us. We Adansimai, we are not for NPP or NDC. NDC, NPP, they are all subset of Adansimai. Yes. So we are in need of the person who help us. Yes. So whether sack or not, we vote for him.
Sure.
True or false, Asiama will continue next 4 years.
Yes. Yeah. Inshallah. Mm. All right. Okay, so now let's get to some of the women here. Mommy. Also, dear na ekoswo wadwim.
Dear ekoswo madwene me ne se, amakwansia ma MP abakwa MP abakọ. Amakwansia ma ba yanwuma pa wo ye ma adanse na ofofuo no. Ebru yadwene ente ase so. Ente wase metoma ba ma asiama. Se asiama ni wode a MPP nsu ni ho.
Me nsu me dear ne se, lawyer siama ba ye no. Ye hu se MPP ebia bakọ bia bakọ MPs bebra bakọ. Yanya she bibia wo kroma bia this na ye no kora na make am na lawyer same about 4 years no enwuma pa wa beye metu we mika se pesu adwuma kora nka me mikosu abi wa fa mai obi okora ti aware ase nso osu adwuma ai wo pon no ho nka la odo mo ko police asoja fo nurse fo ne nyina teachers fo lawyer same aye bi wa boa yan menyi ne same pe bia ko 4 years aye de lawyer same aye da Enti nana so asoma lawyer siama yesra ne se lawyer siama we din boshe so tinana man in parliament na won to anwuma so
no.
Papa me dey lawyer siama oho na migina cause papa no aye bebre na maye oye nyame nipa onwe ono nkwa ne yafunu odwuna man san nyina ne sakata obi aso lawyer ba ha no we nya 4 years 3 years ani e chim no kwan And so still, Papa no ignore na so. The assessor why ye biya why ye? And my pa was why ye no? Akwasinti the nisa to so. Papa name to me anye. But kakwa ye na aso ye ni. And the person akwa 24 years ni so. Na why vye ni nyuma no Papa no? Ye twa mani a twa mani biyo. Lord nana ye ba twa mani na san twa mani lawyer. Oga ni jina.
Mensho master me ne se lawyer buy and why ye biya my ing. We akwa la akura lawyer buyadiye. Obuade ankasa ni oni ne beka bi odi me paacha o enso e ba ya si lawyer muade ni poka ye bi oboa nti lawyer si amade eta na chi ba bi obeko bi eta na chi
I'm now in another community Dajini. We understand is also a community where a lot of people are mobilizing votes for the incumbent MP. In fact, the MP who has been sacked, that's Mr. Andrew Amakwensiama. So we are getting to know from the people why they are taking this decision to still rally behind the sacked MP. So I'm moving to the people. We understand they have been organizing some kind of programs where they will be inviting MP to talk to the residents within this area. This is the leader for the team, in fact, the spokesperson for the team, Mills. So tell us why you are taking this decision.
Okay, we are taking this decision because we've had MPs from our constituency for the past 16 years. I think it started from 1992 to NDC won the seat in 1992. 1996 MPP won with Honorable FIFA. 2000 he won, and then with his third term, he died on the seat, which was 2006. Honorable Obron Saki. He spent 2 years and then went on to win in the election till 2010. 2012. So Honorable Atabwafo also came. But with all these MPs, You've not had a competent MP more than Honorable Esiama. He has been the most competent MP for many constituencies has ever had. That's why we are taking this initiative. And then we are supporting him with all that we have.
So what is the position of the campaign team of Andrew Amwako Esiama?
We are just trying to tell them that what they are doing to the constituency, it is not going to help the constituency. And every constituency needs development.
You want development.
You want development. And the man is doing the development. Why should he change him? Why should he change him? Just yesterday we heard that they've taken a seat from the parliament. The parliament is already closed. So if you take the seat, why are you taking the seat to?
It's politically motivated.
It's politically motivated. The Speaker of Parliament, they are forcing him, they are pressuring him to do that. And that one, it doesn't put any fear on us. What we are saying is that Lawyer Siama is the MP for Adanse Fomuna. He has spent 4 years for us, and we want him to continue what he's doing.
Following the decision by Parliament to dismiss the MP for this area, we have been trying to find out the reaction of traditional leaders within this area, but they have not been available for comments. For City News, I'm Edward Upon Marfo, Fomuna constituency, Ashanti region.
We move away from the Fomina marches and go to the special prosecutor, Martin Amadu, because he has advised former President Mahama to avail himself to the office for interrogation. If he disagrees with being named government official one in the Airbus bribery scandal. Now, the former president lashed out at the special prosecutor after his name was mentioned in the report of the corruption risk assessment conducted into the Japa royalties deal by Martin Amadu. The former president described the inclusion of his name in the report as stupid. But in a press statement, the special prosecutor asked the former president to wise up. Here are excerpts of the statement.
In view of the fact that I was making an assessment report on Ajapa and other related matters thereto, I found it necessary to make observations on other matters related thereto on which discrete analysis of the risk of corruption and anti-corruption assessments had been undertaken leading to investigations to demonstrate the essence of anti-corruption assessments. The evidence gathered in the case of the Republic versus Samuel Adam Mahama and others points to one and only one person as government official one. His Excellency former President John Dramani Mahama, the former Vice President of Ghana, is elected government official one. The special prosecutor owes that exercise of discretion to his vast experience over the years, his responsibility to maintain national stability, and his conscience as a patriotic anti-corruption crusading Ghanaian. There is no question of stupidity, of cowardice about it. Any person aspiring to be the president for a second term who does not know that a cardinal principle in security and intelligence is that caution is the best part of valor was not and is not worth the vote. Your Excellency, the wise and the brave former President John Dramani Mahama, man up, wise up and be brave enough to come with two lawyers of your own choice to be cautioned and interrogated by this office to demonstrate your valor and wisdom as not being elected government official one and also as not being the first guarantor to Samuel Adam Mahama's passport application.
You're still watching the City Newsroom. My name is Vivian Kai. Look, I'm here with
Umaru Sanda Amadu.
When we come back, we'll look at how ready the Electoral Commission is for the December polls.
Don't go away.
Rigworld Solutions, forging the frameworks of Ghanaian industry. Engineering solutions from the heart of Takrade, Kejebil. At Rigworld Solutions, we manufacture industrial bolts and nuts, fasteners, hoses and fittings for the extractive and petrochemical industries. World-class products with local expertise. Locate our factory in Kejebil, of the Takrade Takwa Road. Call 0302 949917. or 0540-107504. Email enquiries@rigworldsolutions.com. Rigworld Solutions, crafted in Ghana, engineered for the world.
Hi, my name is Salamatu. Yes, these are both me. You see, before Free SHS, my life could have taken two very different paths. The SHS path depended on how much money my parents had, what sacrifices they were willing to make, and whether they would send me or my little brother Issa to SHS. The other path is what would have become of me if there was no Free SHS. But today, thanks to Free SHS, my future is bright and promising.
Congratulations, you have an A.
It's a boy.
Instead of depending on others, I will stand on my own feet and help my family. Free SHS is where my dreams for a better future and the dreams of thousands of young girls become a reality. Don't let NBC take it away from us. Vote for NPP and give all Ghanaian girls a chance for a better future.
You've come a long way from where you started, and in that time, you've upgraded a lot. But have you upgraded your entertainment? When you upgrade to Globe TV Max, everyone gets an upgrade. Football fans can up their game with La Liga and get all new action with the NBA and NFL on a brand new channel, ESPN. The kids will go crazy for the most popular kids shows, and family night is sorted with blockbuster movies on TNT. Plus, our local celebrities will keep you connected to your continent, while our general entertainment channels will take you international. There's a whole lot for the whole family when you upgrade to GoTV Max. So make the move today and give your family an upgrade they'll love. GoTV. Live it, love it.
It's you, Wafa Kofi.
Hello.
It's good I saw you here.
Really?
You know, with businesses restarting after the lockdown, getting funds has been really difficult. To pay for some of the goods in high demand, and my supply is no longer selling on credit.
Sister Ama, my financial partner is Advance Savings and Loans. Advance stayed by my side all through the COVID crisis. They offered me grace period. They also gave me advice on how to manage my business. And now they are here to help me clear my containers by offering me a loan.
Are you sure they are giving out loans even during the COVID pandemic?
Yes, Advance Ghana has you covered.
So that's how I got a loan to stock up my shop.
Call us on 0800-355-355 or visit our nearest branch for our various loan and deposit products. Advance, your preferred financial partner.
You're welcome back. Now, there will be over 38,000 polling stations going into the December election, and this is according to the Electoral Commission. The Electoral Commission has also reiterated its confidence in the credibility of voters registered, despite the many disagreements and concerns that have been raised by various stakeholders. Director of Electoral Services at the Electoral Commission, Dr. Sribor Kwaku, spoke to City News 6 to Don Ulo on the Commission's readiness for the December polls.
Create new centers. We decided that we want to, one, because of the COVID, we wanted to reduce the queuing in at the polling centers. So the commission decided that we'll put the threshold at 749. So that any center that is more than 750, so more than 749 is split. So there are some centers which have been split into five. Some centers have been split into four, some into three, and some into two. So all the centers that were more than 749 have been split. So the splitting has created around 5,000 plus. So no, they are not new polling stations, but they are split. So in that case, you see that 621, 622, I mean, they are the same 622s, but because of the spread that we have gotten two centers.
Is this across the country, or they are concentrated in particular regions?
It's all over the country, but they are common at the areas which are densely populated, because if the place densely populated, that's why they have the long queue. It should also interest you to know that there are polling stations with six voters. There are polling stations with 18 voters. So That's how it is.
Have these been the excess? I mean, have they been gazetted already?
It's the same code, the same police station. So it's sisters, A1 and 2, but the same sisters. Okay. So they are not new police station. That's what we call it. They are spirit police station. We have not created new police station. If you get new police station, it will assume new name, it will assume new code. Then we are talking of gazetting because we are talking of new police station.
Still in politics, an independent presidential candidate, Alfred Kwame Asiedu-Walker, says he voted on the 7th of December. He will institute a policy to stop the monthly payment of salaries. He says he will ensure that workers are paid every 2 weeks. According to him, the bi-weekly salary structure will help individuals who solely depend on their remuneration for survival. Now, addressing the Ga-Manche King, Taki Tekuchu II, and his entourage, Mr. Walker said he will also ensure that more jobs are created to engage the country's youth.
Should we make it? I've also proposed bi-weekly salaries. 2 weeks, 2 weeks. Payday must be 2 weeks. Should we have it? I see no reason why somebody being paid 500 or even 1,000 cedis a month shouldn't get half of it every 2 weeks, so they are relieved in their problems. You have people who have borrowed money before the month is over, and they cannot even pay their rent. They've borrowed money to support their children in hospitals, and they can't even pay their rent. So yes, we are going to institute some policies that are done elsewhere in this world. We are going to bring a lot of sanity in the system here. I've talked about reopening the parks and gardens as well. Immediate job employment for people to plant trees, beautiful flowers on the streets of Accra, for example, or in the country. We must promote beauty. I've also called, and I've said so, architecture, environment, beauty environment shapes behavior. If you have somebody who goes to a beautiful place, even the sight of the environment will change their behavior.
Now, the New Patriotic Party's parliamentary candidate for the Bogatanga Central Constituency, Rex Asanga, says he is poised to unseat the incumbent Member of Parliament, Isaac Adongo.
He believes Isaac Adongo has failed to lobby for development projects in the constituency, but the incumbent MP disagrees and is certain of a resounding victory. City News' Upper East Regional Correspondent Frederick Awuni reports.
The Bogatanga Central Constituency is within the capital of the Upper East Region, which was carved out of the then Upper Region in 1983. The constituency has a population of over 66,000, with most of them being either farmers or petty traders. The Bogatanga Regional Hospital, the Bogatanga Technical University, and other secondary schools are situated in this constituency. It is the commercial business district of the region. Yet, many communities in this constituency are still confronted with issues of potable drinking water, deplorable road network, and access to electricity, among others. The National Democratic Congress has won the Boga Central parliamentary seat 5 times, while the current flag bearer of the People's National Convention, David Apasira, also won the seat 2 consecutive times. The 2016 parliamentary elections witnessed a keen contest between the NDC's Isaac Adongo and the NPP's Rex Asanga. The race ended with Mr. Adongo winning over 25,000 of the votes to beat his main contender, Rex Asanga, who polled 15,610 votes. Interestingly, the two will battle it out again in the upcoming 2020 parliamentary elections. Both candidates have intensified their campaigns with their posters dotted all over the constituency and reaching out to their constituents to vote massively for them to emerge victorious. The incumbent Member of Parliament for the area, Isaac Adongo, on the ticket of the NDC, is optimistic of a resounding victory based on his performance.
In the last 3 years, I have so far catered for 570 students. Out of 27 electoral areas in Bolgatanga Central. This year, I'm doing an average of 10 students per electoral area. That should give me about 270 students. So in total, I'll be hitting 840 students that have provided stipend to assist them cope with the needs of their schools over in 4 years. I think that is a remarkable work. Healthcare is a major problem. Even when I want to enhance the health facilities, the demand for critical life-saving interventions are so enormous. In the last 3 days, I've had to deal with 3 medical emergencies, very critical one that requires surgeries at TTH and has to be done immediately, and I've had to deal with that. I have close to 20 such medical emergencies that I have dealt with in the last couple of years. I think I come to this race with a very strong strength, and it is my strength that would win the race for me, just like it did in 2016 when I was an unknown quantity in the constituency. Today, I am the love of the town. And I'm not the love of the town because of my advocacy work that I do in Parliament alone, but also because I am touching lives. And those lives are telling their stories. And everywhere I go, people are giving testimony to the benefit of my leadership. And it is that leadership that would give them the opportunity to give me a much more resounding victory. Because even in the past, they trusted in my instinct. But now they have something tangible to put their fingers to. And that is what will give me the strength.
But the NPP's parliamentary candidate, Rex Asanga, is confident of unseating Isaac Adongo.
Oh, by the grace of God, I think that there will be a very big surprise in the Bolgatanga constituency come December 7th. If you go around, if you just go around the constituency, and we have been around all over, people don't even know the sitting MP. He's never visited them in the 4 years of his stewardship. And this is not the first time he's going around to solicit their votes. And if he was even doing something, if he cared about the constituents and he was facilitating some access to resources for them, but he is not doing that, and he is not known in the constituency by communities, and so he just comes, pops up now looking for their votes. And because they know me as somebody who has been with them and has been solving a lot of some of their problems, I'm not the MP, but if you get to know the number of communities and people, individuals who are coming to me and asking me to intercede or to intervene, you know, in some of the problems that and challenges that they face, you'll be surprised. And so that is my advantage. So my motivation for going to Parliament is that I want to contribute to making Bolga the star, you know, of the region.
Some voters and constituents of the Bolga Central constituency have been speaking to City News on their choice of candidate.
He's done a lot for the constituency in terms of development, in terms of he has done a lot. He has helped a lot of the youth, especially the education. Most of the youth, he has helped them to acquire skill. A lot he has also assisted to acquire jobs, permanent jobs. So we are for Isaac Adongo, and surely we know he's winning, hands down.
Adongo has actually performed very well in his first term as a member of parliament for Bolga Central constituency. He has given more than we expect. He has put in the name of Bolga Central on top of the globe. The name of Bolga Central is known even in the international level, and that is by virtue of the fact that Adongo performed very well, both in Parliament and also in his constituency here.
When you look at Rex, he's somebody who is a developmental orientated person and is very gentle. He doesn't talk just like that. Because when you look at Isaac Adongo, he's been there for 4 years. Apart from he insulting big men in Accra, he do nothing in Bolga here. We can't point anything that he came and did for us. So I don't think voting him is waste. it's waste voting, because we need somebody who have sympathy for the town. Come and develop the town for us, not to just vote because I'm NDC, I'll just vote somebody who cannot do anything. Even when this flooding happens, we didn't see him to come and sympathize with our people. So how can I vote with such person?
He have not any government appointment, but his effort managed to move with the educational sector. If you look at the secondary schools, there's no secondary school. This man didn't put this project there. If you come down to the street, look at the street lights, and look at the developmental project, they are there, uncountable. But when you go to the NDC, we never see one, mention one, even toilet for the people at the East Orin area, we never see. What he very good in it is only to challenge Dr. Mamoudou Bawuya. But talking about his own constituency, about the development, having a capacity building, he's done nothing in Bawuya constituency. Nothing.
The Bogatanga Central constituency is one seat to watch out for. But both parliamentary candidates for the NPP, Rex Asanga, and the NDC incumbent member of parliament, Isaac Adongo, are both poised for victory come December 7th. Will the NDC incumbent member of parliament, Isaac Adongo, retain the seat for the first time, or will it swing to the NPP Rex Asanga? December 7th will be the decider. Reporting for Citi News, I'm Frederick Awuni, Bogatanga.
And in our studios here, I am Umaru Sanda Amadu.
Vivian Kai Lokko.
This is the Election Bureau on Citi TV. Still ahead on the bulletin, well, the campaigns are heated, but have people thrown away all cautions in relation to COVID-19?
Stay with us, we'll be right back.
Sunana Abdurrazak, last week I received a message from Bet Planet. Come on, now we're building ticket. Nadan Jin Saya, Mammy City's Benson. Come back, we had a Makuma, Gashina, Gasuna Nakai. I'm gonna go to Kaman Gaskiani. Mana Sunchi, now go to Bet Planet. Now go to Makuma.
If you win, no one will like Bet Planet. Babebe, Bodulo. If you win, no one will like.
During tough times, we need a competent leader we can trust to keep us all safe.
Nana gave me free water when I needed it most to keep me clean and safe from COVID-19.
Nana gave me lower cost of internet during COVID-19 to operate my small business from home.
Nana told us to trust him to keep our children safe from COVID-19 when we send them back to school. Nana was right.
Nana gave me free electricity in my hour of need during COVID-19.
Nana told us to trust him to keep Ghana safe from COVID-19.
Looking for something new this November? Looking for star-studded suspense?
It's what rich, entitled people do when threatened. They conceal the ugly truths to protect themselves.
Maybe you're in search of true love.
Roses are red, violets are blue. I got a crush on you, baby, would you be my boo?
What about a bit of family drama? Need something to keep the kids entertained?
We're ready to help with the case, Mira. We'll look for a clue.
Perhaps criminally good comedy is your thing.
That is so cute!
What
Whatever you're in the mood for, look no further than DSTV.
Thank you, sir. Hello, my name is Samuel Ofori, a film actor and a film director. Because of the nature of my job, the taste for quality things is endless. Quality phones, quality laptops, quality TV sets. Let me show you my secret. Here is Franco Trading Enterprise. My secret for quality laptops, quality phones, quality TV sets, accessories, come on, external hard drive, pen drive, name it. For bulk purchase and retails, come to Franco Trading Enterprise. They'll reduce the price for you. Franco Trading Enterprise. Home quality.
In Ghana, the law enjoins all drivers and passengers in a moving vehicle to wear a seatbelt. No excuse is good enough for not wearing a seatbelt. Seatbelts that are fitted in vehicles are adjustable, so please adjust it to suit you. Let it rest as close as possible to the body. As a driver, before you drive off, ensure everyone else, especially children in the vehicle, have fastened their seatbelts. The airbag is not an alternative to a seatbelt, because in the event of a crash, only the fastened seatbelt will stop a passenger from being thrown far forward. So buckle up. Stop road crashes now. Stay alive.
This road safety education is brought to you by the National Road Safety Authority.
Responsibly. Not for sale to peasants under 18. Not recommended for pregnant women. This advertisement has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
Welcome back to the City Newsroom. Now, with an increase in campaign activities by political parties ahead of the December polls, some stakeholders have raised concerns about the seeming neglect of COVID-19 safety protocols by political parties and their supporters.
Some have attributed the rise in Ghana's active cases to these campaign events, but the Information Minister, Kojo Ponkrumah, says no available data suggests that political activities have contributed to the rise in the cases.
If it is true, then it flows that you should be seeing a widespread
in all regions.
In all of these regions where you are having all of these activities. If it is true, you should be seeing it. The data should be supporting it. The data does not support that. It's a nice argument to make, especially when you want to take politicians on, but the data is not supporting that. Second, the data, as was mined by the Public Health Department of the Ghana Health Service, shows us that we're having a lot more issues in offices and workplaces where you have enclosed activity happening. I'm sure you saw him present the data to you.
The Information Minister, Kojo Ponkrumah, is, however, urging the country's security agencies and managers of enclosed areas to ensure strict adherence to the health and safety precautions to help curb the spread of the virus.
We will reiterate a call to the security agencies and to the managers, particularly of enclosed places, to ensure that compliance with the wearing of masks at least is enforced. All of us as citizens have a responsibility to ensure that the other parts of it, where, you know, washing our hands, using of the hand sanitizer, we do it. But particular call goes out to the security agencies and the operators of enclosed places to ensure that the wearing of masks is enforced. So if you look at this particular slide, 1st to 14th of October, 432 new cases. And then in the last 2 weeks of October, that's where the challenge has been, 1,229 new cases.
Speaking at the COVID-19 press briefing in Accra, the director of the Ghana Health Service, Dr. Patrick Kumar Bwaje, bemoaned the increasing disregard for the safety protocols, particularly the wearing of nose masks in the national capital, Accra.
Mask wearing, appropriate mask wearing, have declined from 44.3% to 10%, and in some settings, 5%. Those not wearing masks at all have increased from 18% to 72%, which is a major worry. And these are all in Accra, which is where the epicenter of the focus is. However, there have been some moderate increase in people who are wearing the mask correctly. What it tells us is that people are learning how to wear the mask well, but people have also stopped wearing the mask. And so I believe that if you're able to get people to wear the mask, more people will be wearing it correctly, and that will lead to better results.
Currently, Ghana's active cases stand at 1,156, with 320 deaths recorded. According to government, new sampling centers will be set up to facilitate contact tracing, testing, and treatment.
We want to establish additional sample collection sites in Accra so that we can have more control and have more information. Two will be in Accra and one will be in Tema, so that we can able to test and take all the information we want. We are going to repost surveillance officers in all these labs so that the initial information is taken from every potential person who has come there, whether you are exposed or you are traveling, you are going for a testing view. But even those who walk into the lab and want to travel, they are positive, nothing happens. They get positive and all they do is, okay, you can't travel now. But there's a lot that has to be done.
Well, that's it for today's edition of the City Newsroom. Visit our website, citynewsroom.com, for more stories.
Download the City News app from Google Play Store and keep updated on the go. Subscribe to CityTube on YouTube for more exclusive video contents from City TV.
You can also watch City TV on DSTV channel 363 and Go TV channel 182. My name is Vivian Kai, Lokko.
And mine is Umaru, Sanda, Amadu. Thank you for watching.